Let's turn to the March 27th letter, which you received and read March 28th, the Mueller letter.
Mm-hmm.
Correct?
Yes.
When did you have the conversation with Bob Mueller about that letter that you've referenced?
I think it was on the 28th.
Same day that you read it? When did you first learn of the New York Times and Washington Post stories that would make the existence of this letter public, the ones that came out last night?
I think it could have been yesterday, but I'm not sure.
When they contacted you to ask for any comment?
They didn't contact me.
Contacted DOJ to ask for any comment?
I can't actually remember how it came up, but someone mentioned it.
So you, at some point you knew that the Mueller letter was going to become public, and that was probably yesterday?
I think so.
Okay. When did you decide to make that letter available to us in Congress?
This morning.
Would you concede that you had an opportunity to make this letter public on April 4th when Representative Crist asked you a very related question?
I don't know what you mean by related question. It seems to me it'd be a very different question.
I can't even follow that down the road. That's a masterful hair splitting. Letter references enclosed documents and enclosed materials, right? Are those the same things as what you called the executive summaries that Mueller provided you?
With this letter?
Yes.
Yes.
It's all the same document.
I'm sorry.
When you talk about the executive summaries that Mueller provided you, they are the documents that were the enclosed documents with that letter, which we have not been provided.
I think they were.
They
have been provided them. They're in the report. They're the summaries in the report.
It's the language of the report in the report? There's nothing else that he provided you then?
I think that's what he provided.
Okay. If there is anything else, will you provide it to us if it's different in any form? It's odd to be given a letter without the attachments to it when the attachments are referenced in the letter.
I think they were the redacted versions of the executive summaries that are embedded in the report.
Can we get that just to be sure?
Sure.
Great. Thank you. You agree that none of that material was either grand jury 6E or presented a risk to intelligence sources and methods or would interfere or compromise ongoing investigation or were affected by executive privilege?
There were redactions made in the executive summaries. But as I said, I wasn't interested in putting out summaries, period.
Well, you know, this is another hair-splitting exercise because Bob Mueller, who I think we all agree is fairly credible, actually described your letter as a summary. So you can say it wasn't a summary, but Mueller said it was a summary. And I don't think...
I wasn't interested in summarizing the whole report. As I say, I was stating the bottom-line conclusions of the report.
Your letter says that it's intended to describe... I quote your words, describe
the report, meaning volume one dealt
when
with
this. When you describe
this,
the report in four pages and it's a 400-page report, I don't know why you're caviling about whether it's a summary.
Because I state in the letter that I'm stating the principal conclusions. Let me also say that, you know, Bob Mueller is the equivalent of a U.S. attorney. He was exercising the powers of the attorney general subject to the supervision of the attorney general. He's part of the Department of Justice. His work concluded when he sent his report to the Attorney General. At that point, it was my baby, and I was making a decision as to whether or not to make it public, and I effectively overrode the regulations, used discretion to lean as far forward as I could to make that public, and it was my decision how and when to make it public, not Bob Mueller's.
With respect to the OLC opinion that informed Bob Mueller's decision, as he describes in the report, do you agree that that is merely an executive opinion and that under our Constitution, the decision as to what the law is made by the judicial branch of the United States government?
I'm sorry, could you...
With respect to the OLC opinion that informed Mueller's decision not to make a recommendation on obstruction, as he said in his report, do you concede that that is an executive opinion and that under our constitutional system, what the law is gets decided by the judicial branch of government?
Yes.
Is there any way for the OLC's opinion to be tested by the judicial branch of government to see if it's correct or not?
None that comes to mind.
And it could be wrong, could it not?
I guess hypothetically it could be wrong.
And certainly there are respected legal minds that disagree with it, correct?
Excuse me?
There are many respected legal commentators and professors and lawyers who disagree with it, correct?
It's very hard to find lawyers that agree to on anything.
So the interesting thing to me is that it goes on to say that because of the OLC opinion, we have to give the president an extra benefit of the doubt because he is denied his day in court where he could exonerate himself. That seems like a fallacy to me, because if you are the president of the United States, you can either waive or readily override the OLC opinion and say, I'm ready to go to trial. I want to exonerate myself. Let's go. Could you not?
How is this relevant to my decisions?
It's relevant
because I assumed that there was no OLC opinion.
Well, we have a report in front of us that says that this influenced the outcome. And in particular, it says it influenced the outcome because it deprived the president of his ability to have his day in court. And my point to you is that the president could easily have his day in court by simply waiving or overriding this OLC opinion that has no judicial basis, correct?
Well, I don't think that there was anything to have a day in court on. I think that the government did not have a prosecutable case.
But Mueller obviously didn't agree because he up to you. He said that he could neither confirm nor deny that there was a prosecutable case here. He left that to you. And when he did, he said, and you apparently have agreed, that this OLC opinion bears on it and that it would be unfair to the president to put him to the burden of being indicted and not having the ability to be charged.
I don't want to characterize how Bob's thought process on this.
I'm not asking you to characterize it. It's in his report. He's put it in writing.
I'm not sure what he means by that in the report.
With respect to the word, can I have a minute? I just want to nail down, you used the word spying about authorized DOJ investigative activities.
Are you talking about my testimony before the House Appropriations?
Yes. Okay. In the entirety of your previous career in the Department of Justice, including as Attorney General, have you ever referred to authorized department investigative activities officially or publicly as spying? I'm not asking for private conversation.
I'm not going to abjure the use of the word spying. I think, you know, my first job was in CIA, and I don't think the word spying has any pejorative connotation at all.
The question
is always whether or not it's authorized and adequately predicated spying. I think spying is a good English word that, in fact, doesn't have synonyms because it is the broadest word incorporating really all forms of covert intelligence collection. So I'm not going to back off the word spying, except I will say I'm not suggesting any pejorative, and I use it frequently, as do media.
When did you decide to use it? Was it off the cuff in the hearing that day, or did you go into that hearing intending to use the word spying?
It was actually off the cuff, to tell you the truth, and the congressman from Schatz from Hawaii.
It was here? Shaheen?
No.
Whoever it was, go ahead.
Yeah, when he challenged me and said, you want to change your language, I was actually thinking, like, what's the issue? I don't consider it a pejorative. But frankly, we went back and looked at press usage, and up until all the FOIA outrage a couple of weeks ago, it's commonly used in the press to refer to authorized activities, such as referring to the FISA court as the spy court.
But it's not commonly used by the department.
What?
It is not commonly used by the department. My time is
commonly used by me.
Thank you very much. We'll come back at 10 till 1. Thank you.